In Canvas lesson 5, we have to use temporary sprites and create game result. When you touch a sprite character, it has to be disappeared and bloodstain replace it for the short period of time. This is basically what the first we have to do. So currently we have this scenario lesson 4 completed. So we see that character is just disappearing. So after updating in Canvas 5, we want this kind of like a blood stain replace the character. And there is no animation or move for this blood stain. This temporary sprite, in most sense, like much simpler than the first we created. The only new complexity comes from the fact that they have to be disappeared after a while. So copy, right-click and save as the temporary sprite on the left, if you do not have a better one. So I will have this sprite as a temporary sprite. So I can copy this, save as a picture. So for example, save my sprite here. Let's say it's temp sprite. So then go to the picture that I just saved, copy, and paste picture in the drawable folder of your current project. Right click, paste. Okay. The next you have to create new class called temp sprite Java in your project. So I'm going to do this. So go to the Java side. And the content of this class will be as following. So we have a private X and Y variables, the position of the sprite. We have a bitmap of a sprite representation. We have int variable life, 15. So kind of like a variable that will be counting 15 ticks, kind of like a 15 frames per second or 15 calls of onDraw method. So after this 15 ticks, the sprite should disappear. We have a list of sprites accumulated. We have constructor for this class, which is, has a list of sprites, position x, y, and bitmap variable. So we draw the sprite at the position x, y, and at the same time, after tick will decrease to the minus, to minus 1, to 0. We will decrease the life property of the temp sprite and we'll remove sprite from the temporary list. It's kind of like a little bit a complicated structure for the temp sprite because it has also a list of them. So why we need a list of them? Because we will be constantly updating the list of the temp sprites in our model. So let's go to the game view, and the game view will be creating two variables. One variable is bitmap temp sprites that will be connecting to the raw drawable temp file. So the temp file is already copied here. So another line will be a list of the temporary sprites here. Just declare it, not initialize. So another thing is we have to add here one more for loops. For int I is less than temp size minus 1, I greater than 1, I minus minus, we iterate backwards to avoid errors in the temp sprite list. We get items in the I position and draw this on canvas. Alright, and finally we need to add temporary sprites in moment of touch collision. So just let's go to the moment of the touch collision here. So that this is touch event. So we when collision happened with the touch event, we play sound, we remove sprite from the list, the normal sprite, right? And then we have to add temporary sprite. So temporary sprite will be calling constructor that we just discussed with the list of sprites, temporary position, and temp sprite BMP. What is a temp x temp y? So temp x and temp y, this is a temporary variable taking x and y coordinates of the onTouch event in this canvas. All right, so this is all changes we create for displaying temporary bloodstain. So let's try to run the project. So let's see how it works. Yeah, it looks like a temp sprites right now displaying for 15 milliseconds. So what is the disadvantage of this solution at this moment? If you try to eliminate sprite in the border, you see the stain is not visible. So you have to fix this somehow, because that's not good, right? Yeah, you're quite lucky enough if you get it at least partially, but sometimes stain is not visible at all. So that should be fixed, especially in this case, right? Let's go back to our document, Canvas Game Lesson 5, to the individual section. So individual work for the temporary sprite. The blood bitmap center has to be in XY coordinates. So we had a situation when the blood is down or left from the where we press, so you need to fix it. So blood stain should be centered exactly in the middle where you click. Another situation, when we press sprite, any part of the stain should not be passed outside of the screen. So please take this fact into consideration as well. So stain can be should be completed visibly with the screen boundaries. And the last one, modify the code so blood stain will paint it under the sprite's image, not on the top of the image. So drawing should give us impression that the blood is in the background. So I can just show you again what does it mean. So you just see the blood on the top, right? That should be fixed underneath. That's pretty easy to fix. Alright, so what will be individual work for the project for the final version? Finally, for this file part of the assignment, you have to provide some individual modifications. For example, include the score to the game. It could be the text field on the top of the screen to update the current score. Different sounds. And include a timer, maybe a timer to the game in order to record the time you need to eliminate all bad ones and get the best score in the same time. So we should not try to touch any of the good ones. So the time and score could be saved and used for statistics purposes. All right, so any other extra features may be done by for extra bonuses. Consider more different characters in the game to regulate speed in the game, slow, medium, fast, or maybe easy, hard to too hard. And you can implement any other design ideas how to improve the game. All right, so that was a brief video how to proceed with Canvas Lesson 5. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask. Thanks a lot.